Coin Toss presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Both teams are lining up for the kickoff, and we're just about set to get this one underway. Taken from the 10. Whoa, he just took a licking. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. That'll make it second and seven. From their own 29-yard line, second down. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Fires out to his wideout, and they make the stop at around the 50. Change your quarterback, Kirby. You got to wonder what that's going to do to the team morale. It is next man up. They've got to be ready to trust this guy.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
From the 42-yard line, it's second down. Slings it to his tight end, but he drops it.
This is a big first down for this offense. I think it's another good example about how important it is to have an awareness about you as a wide receiver. The wide receiver did a really good job of knowing exactly where the first down marker was, and he made sure to get the route at least to that point, so when he made the catch and got hit, he had the first down.
Second and 13.
From the 40-yard line, second down. Some steam on that throw, and he's tackled around the 36-yard line.
That'll make it 39.
This is the eighth play of this drive.
Game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
First and 10. Ball on the 23-yard line. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Makes it
10th play of the drive.
Larry. Mike four. Party now.
Tackled after decent pickup. They've looked good so far on third down in this drive. Let's see what happens here. Touchdown.
This guy seems to make things happen no matter what kind of space he has to work with. All he needs is a little crease of daylight and forget about it.
And he tacks on the extra point. It was an 11-play, 74-yard drive, and they get it in for seven. The score now, 7-0. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's out to the 30, and down he goes at the 34-yard line. The Panthers and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing well.
Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. When you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan. And I'm sure they're going to see it again today.
And he's knocked out immediately after the catch. That's a deal. From their own 45-yard line. First down.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
That'll bring up second and 12.
Snags that one. So the quarterback completes the slant pattern for about a 9-yard gain.
That'll bring up third and four.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four.
Gain of 5 yards. First down.
Pass complete and taken down immediately.
Nothing flashy at all, but now that first down marker is a lot closer.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. And he's taken down around the 29-yard line.
Call it a gain of 8 yards. First down.
He's at the 20. They'll bring him down
right around the 18-yard line.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. He's tackled at about the 15-yard line. So at the end of one quarter, the Cavaliers lead 7-0. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. And he throws it away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Caught, open field. He's knocked out of bounds at the 2-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 13 yards.
A touchdown away from a tie. And they'll score. Nice run and a score by the halfback.
And a nice call by the coach there. Just give it to your main man anytime you're near the goal line.
We'll be tied with the extra point. And he converts the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. He's to the 40, brought down at the 40.
When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working.
First and 10, ball on their own 40. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Play action. Going deep.
This guy is mostly used to stop the run, but here he showed that he's not too bad against the pass either.
These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. Talk about a booming punt. My goodness.
Again, it's about stressing special teams. That is why a lot of head coaches usually run these units. It's because field position is just so important in the game.
And he makes it out to about the 8-yard line. It's second down, 7 to go. Ball on the 8. Throws complete, and he's hit hard behind the line. And they'll lose a yard there.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
Shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang out of the ball. And that'll make it fourth down.
It was a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
He really got a hold of that one. He's taken down at the 46. Well, that was a great punt, and there was even better coverage on the return. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll make it second and 7.
From their own 49-yard line, second down. Run up the middle.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
From the 37-yard line, first down. They go right back to him, and this
this time, they get him in the backfield.
Think about the speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
He has some room. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 31-yard line. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Setting up the play action. And that sets them up with a first and goal.
Good job by the offensive line to pick up the linebacker on the blitz. That gave the quarterback enough time to find his man for a nice game.
And they bring him down for a sack on the play.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense the next time this quarterback drops.
And he gets the touchdown. Two-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
And Brad, right now, the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lanes.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's tackled at the 31. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Receiver. Tackle right around the 48-yard line.
Boy, this is a really risky call by the defense. When you send both your corners, you leave yourself vulnerable to some passes downfield if those guys don't get to the quarterback in time.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 48. Quick throw out to the receiver. He's taken down right around the 44-yard line. Not a bad little play there.
Yeah, this is a nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice game.
Tailback with a catch and up for the first. And they make the stop around the 39-yard line. First down. It's first and 10. Ball on the 39. Throw, he caught it. He's got the corner, and they push him out at the 29.
This was a great call. From here, it looked like the defense was fooled and reacted a little bit late to the screen.
Quick throw, and down he goes, right around the 24-yard line. We've got a second and 5. Ball on the 24. Makes the catch, and look out, and they're in. Touchdown. And a nice catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
And doesn't it always seem like he just finds a way to get open? They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. He splits the uprights with the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He just drills this one. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
There's the strike complete.
Tackle made at the 41.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass. Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
They bring the quarterback down. Defense hoping for another sack here on third and long. He gets hit out of bounds at the 50.
That makes it fourth and inches.
So they're going to try to determine if the receiver had possession and was inbounds or not. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll get a second look at it here and determine if he was inbounds when he hauled it in.
And that play happened so fast that it was very tough to tell if he was able to get a foot down or not.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field stands.
Well, I think the play warranted a review, but the call on the field stands. Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And as the defense comes back out, you can be sure they're thinking about that score they surrendered the last time around.
Well, it's one thing to have speed. It's another thing to have an idea of what you're doing and how to attack the defense. And right now, these wide receivers clearly have done an outstanding job of being able to make their reads and getting out of their breaks, and the quarterback put the ball right on the money.
So at the end of the half, we're deadlocked right now at 14.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, that is more important than turnovers. Now, so far, neither defense has been able to force one in this game, but you never know when that opportunity is going to come up.
No, and people look at turnovers and they assume that it's luck a lot of times, but a lot of times it's preparation. It's being able to know that when certain teams line up, like South Carolina back in 2002, in a certain formation where it's Tucson open stud, and they got three receivers to my side, and I know it's a rollout pass. As a defensive end, I widened my stance a little bit, came upfield, hit the quarterback as he was throwing it. Next thing you know, the ref signals his hands up in the air, and you get 6 points for it. So you can definitely be prepared, and that's how you force those turnovers.
We've done what we can do here at halftime. Time to get you back out to the second half. We'll keep an eye on everything going on in college football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready with a call.
Heading into the third quarter now. Tie ball game. We're set to resume play. He's out to the 30. Oh, he got nailed on that one. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. And he's tackled around the 35-yard line. We've got a second and nine here. Ball on the 35. He scrambles. He sails it long. No, incomplete.
Number 86 was the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it third and nine.
tackled right away.
Number eight makes the tackle at the 47-yard line.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 47. And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five-receiver look. And a quick throw. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. To the 20. To the 10. And he scores. Touchdown.
This offense just has so many weapons to defend. They've got some genuine playmakers.
The PAT. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. It's been an impressive game by this safety, Kirk.
You know, I've been very impressed with this guy's ability to read plays and just react so quickly. He's got such amazing instincts out there that it always seems to be in the right place at the right time. And I'll tell you, the other thing that's unique is the offense seems to be spending so much time with him that it's freeing up the other defenders to be able to come in and also help him out in making plays.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Nice run there.
Second and six.
From their own 29-yard line, it's second down. They'll spread the field with five wide. Got a man. Watch out here. Dives forward.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
He's at midfield. That's a great tackle at the 48. From the 48-yard line, it's first down. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. He makes it to the 35-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. Second and eight, ball on the 33.
Mike four.
He gets another carry. He makes his way to about the 18. It's the ninth play of the drive. Out of bounds.
at the 4-yard line. They're really putting a nice drive together right now.
And it seems right now this defense is having a hard time guessing what the offense is up to.
First down. Chance for 3 or 7 here. First and goal inside the 5. Brought down around the 2-yard line. It's the 11th play of the drive. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. The extra point to tie this game up. Hits the PAT. An 11-play, 75-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running backs.
21-21 ball game. He's out to the 30, and he's taken down the 36-yard line. Both these offenses stepping up and answering the bell. Who's going to blink first here?
Exactly right. I've just been impressed with the way they've been able to execute. I mean, there's a lot of pressure on them. Anytime you're feeling that the other offense can put points up on the board, there's a tendency to want to press. Either one has done that up to this point, and right now it's going to come down to who can continue to execute and put points up.
The offense really came up with a nice drive their last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and 1. He gets out to about the 48-yard line.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Mike 4, Mike 4.
Nice run up the middle.
Call it a gain of 6 yards. That brings him second and 5.
Second and 5 coming up here. Ball on the 46. Bring him down at the 46-yard line. So at the end of 3, we've got a stalemate right now, 21 apiece. Welcome back to the action, fourth quarter. This one will decide it. Tight ball game through 3. Huge, huge play by the defense here early in the fourth quarter, and a big stop in a tie game. He's going to aim this one to the sideline, try to kick it out of bounds. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. So we're early in the fourth quarter. Still a lot of football left, but in a game this tight, every possession is going to make a difference. Hand off, and he's met in the backfield.
A loss of 3 yards on the play. That brings up second and 13.
From their own 17-yard line, second down. Tries to get around the corner. He's out to the 30. He makes his way to about the 38.
Down.
38-yard line.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 38-yard line, it's second down. Quick out to his receiver. He's tackled at the 49.
I credit the quarterback on that pass. He made a great read and delivered a very nice pass for the first down.
Tackle at about the 45.
That makes it second and 14.
From their own 45-yard line, second down. Got it and brought down immediately.
Number six with the tackle at the 49-yard line. That'll bring up third and eight.
Hit immediately. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Just under three to go in regulation. From the 12-yard line, first down. And he hits him hard at the four. Here's play number 10 on the drive. He's taken down right around the 2-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That'll bring up third and inches.
And so it's another third down upcoming here. They're crowding that line of scrimmage. Heading for the corner, and they're in. Touchdown. The play clock's at zero. They took too much time.
Delay of game. Offense.
Just under 2 minutes in the game. And he tacks on the extra point. They're ready for the kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Panthers have sort of set up the defense with this wide receiver doing most of the damage. Do they go away from him or do they do something different?
Well, I think one of two things here for this offense. You either find a way to get your star receiver the football, or in some cases you want to use him as a decoy, maybe take two or three defenders with him, and then open it up for somebody else to be able to make a play.
Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. It's first and 10. Ball on the 40. Under pressure.
Where the defense has to be very frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack. And somehow he's able to throw the ball away.
And he's tackled at the 43. And they get stopped after a short gain.
Yeah, the quarterback better get these guys to the line of scrimmage and hurry up.
Third down now, and they need to get it out to the 50. Quick throw out to the receiver. Tackle made around the 30-yard line. That's a 27 play. That makes it first and 10. From the 30-yard line, first down. A little over a minute in the game. Fires out to his wideout. And they make the stop around the 25-yard line.
The Panthers will use their first time out of the half.
Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Hit immediately.
The defense was ready for that pass and catch, and they did a good job to hold them for such a short game.
This is their last chance. They need a big play here. Under pressure.
Wow, what a battle, and what a stop right there. Congratulations for that defense. That's going to be the ball game.
The whistle hasn't sounded yet. They still have to snap the ball and make sure they don't make any mistakes.
We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. The offense lining up in a victory formation, and he takes a knee.
Second and 12 coming up here. Ball on the 27. The quarterback takes a knee, and that's always a good sign if you're a fan of this team. I'm sure are secure in the knowledge that despite this setback today, they still have one of the best players in the country.
Well, this is a devastating loss, but it's one that they're going to have to put behind them. And as you said, they still have one of the best players in the country. They don't need to deviate their plan. Get back to really what they know, and that's getting the ball to their star player. Next week, I'm sure they'll be fine.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.